亲爱的小伙伴们，大家好，这里是 Vivi 闯硅谷，和你们一起用创新的力量改变世界。我们生活在一个科技日新月异的时代，那么不久前呢，大家一定都还记得我们都在玩任天堂的游戏，那么仿佛转眼之间大家都在满大街的抓 Pokemon Go 了。那么说到游戏呢，今天就要带大家认识一下硅谷最热的 VR 游戏公司之一 Temple Gates。他们是硅谷虚拟现实游戏界的摇滚巨星，就在今年最火爆的 VR Oculus 大会上，脸书 Facebook 的创始人小扎也对他们的游戏赞不绝口。
现在就让我们见识一下硅谷虚拟游戏界的神奇四侠。 Theresa 是团队带头人，硅谷少有的女性总裁，也是游戏开发者，早期因为开发 Cannon Boy 这款游戏而享誉业界。 B 是团队的艺术家 Patrick 3D 模型师，还有编程大师 Todd。
关于 Temple Gates 的神奇四侠，我久仰大名，他们的团队有什么秘密武器，跟我一探究竟吧。
You know, we know that developing VR games is obviously much more complicated than traditional games. Like, there's a shift in paradigm. What is your killer technology?
Well, what we've really got in our corner is a custom engine. So that's pretty unique for a VR development company. Todd and Jeff have written this engine specifically to create VR games. And what that really helps us with is both performance and comfort, which are two big issues for VR developers right now. If you don't have a really high performance level, high frame rate, you're going to run into issues where people might get some motion sickness or the game might not feel right. And because we have complete control over the engine, which is all written in C++, we're able to keep that performance up while we're double drawing all our geometry, while we're pulling off all this optical stuff for virtual reality.
虚拟现实游戏可以让玩家真切地体验 3D 动态环境，同时还可以和周边环境互动。现在这项技术已经发展到可以探测玩家现实的身体动作，并实时融合到虚拟游戏中。那么开发者是如何做到的？这其中的感觉又究竟如何？ Vivi 决定亲自体验一下。包括 Temple Gates 在内的游戏开发者都在试图更灵敏地跟踪玩家的身体动作，并投射到虚拟现实环境中。比如说，当你在现实生活中动动头的时候，你的虚拟头部也会跟着移动。这个过程的关键就在于电脑是否能够准确地捕捉到这些动作，解读接收到的信号，并随之反应。 俗话说得好，内容才是王道，虚拟现实呢也不例外。这就是为什么创意和创新才是成功的关键。
How about in content? Being creative in VR games, how challenging is it for you? And then how do you keep up the creativity?
It's really challenging. So that first game that we made, Bizarre, the flying carpet game, is a game where we really tackled this new platform with a lot of gusto, and we just sort of tried all these new tricks that we wanted to. One thing that we did was we put our UI, our user interface, in the stars, so that when you look up, you would see your inventory represented as constellations. And we did things like we allowed the accelerometer data of the headset to pick up whether you're nodding your head or shaking your head, and we used that input to accept or reject quests. There were a lot of really interesting innovations that we did, but what we found was, in the end, users didn't necessarily know how to interact with these totally new things because VR is so new, people are unfamiliar. So what we've done is we've gone from creating our own IP with Bizarre to using board game IP such as Ascension. And that gives us an existing gameplay mechanic so that we can focus our innovations on the UX side. So close.
Virtual 虚拟现实这项技术呢，可以说是席卷全球。根据专家的统计，消费者呢今年将会花费50亿美金在与虚拟现实相关的产品上，而这个数字估计明年还会翻一番。那么大家都知道，我做了多年的财经主播，关于前景这个问题，那是必须要讨论一下的。
So, are you already making money?
We are making money, but the VR market is small. So, one thing we're focused on going forward is we've already made a name for ourselves as a cross-platform VR development studio. So that means you can play our game Ascension on the Vive, the Gear, the Rift, any major VR headset out there, and you can play multiplayer with people from any of those headsets. What we're doing for our upcoming project is we're exploring bringing in users from other platforms as well, such as mobile. And I think that that will help because that's a less risky space to be in as a developer.
And in terms of acquiring and enlarging your customer base, when you design games, do you have some specific age demographics in mind? What is your strategy in acquiring a bigger user base?
So far, what we typically do as a studio is we make the games that we love to play, and we're kids at heart, but we love deep strategy, so we kind of blend these things together, and it's been successful so far. Our strategy is to make a killer game that the bigger companies who are making the headsets are going to want to market for us, because it's going to make their headset look better. So we've been featured by Samsung, we've been featured on the Oculus store, and we're using our content to sort of speak for itself.
China is actually the world's biggest game market. Do you see China in your strategy? Do you have any plans to go into the Chinese market?
Yeah, absolutely. We're seeing that our biggest sales market outside the US is China, just by people who are buying our games right now. And that's with unlocalized versions. So these games haven't been translated into Chinese yet, and we're already seeing the interest there. So we're working on getting them localized, and we're hoping to get that out in the near future, because we'd absolutely love to deliver more to Chinese players.
The industry is changing so fast. Mm-hmm. So in the next couple of years, what would be on the horizon in the gaming, in the VR gaming space?
Because multiplayer is starting to take off, what I'm expecting is we're going to have more representational avatars. So if you and I are playing a game, but you're far away from me, I'll really be able to see your avatar looking like you. Whether that means that there's some kind of depth sensing camera built into the monitor, or you've got a 3D scan of yourself somehow. I think building out these features that are going to enable people to really feel like they're in the same space with someone else. I also think that we're going to be integrating more animation from the real user experience. So, yeah. You know, where your hands are moving, where your body's moving is going to get tracked and brought into the VR experience more than what we're doing right now.
Do you think that interaction is a very important component of VR games?
Absolutely. I think that VR has gotten a reputation as being an isolating platform, but I see that changing because now more and more people have VR headsets. You're able to get that multiplayer pool up to where you'd want it for a multiplayer game. And if you can go and be with your friends and you really see them across from you, you see where they're animating, you hear them talking, you're hanging out with them, even if they live across the country or across the world, that adds a huge value for VR that you don't really have in traditional digital games.
Facebook 的创始人小扎用 VR 拍了一张自拍照，从此呢宣告 VR 时代的到来。那么究竟谁会是这场革命的最大赢家呢？在 Vivi 看来，其实并不玄乎，关键词有两个：互动和联系。像 Temple Gates 这样能够让玩家在 VR 的平台上玩得开心，达到社交的目的，这就是成功了。我是林威 Vivi， 感谢您收看这期的 Vivi 闯硅谷，和你们一起用创新的力量改变世界。我们下次见。